that house?
I didn't know about the committee work. Mm-hmm. All I knew was people sitting on the floor of parliament and people talking, and this one is not talking and this one is that. You know, the talking also works, you know, the contributions. I'm amazed. I sit and I watch the debates and I'm excited. And for the first year, I've studied so much that I can do proper contribution in my next year, because you have to sit and observe and make sure that you don't make blunders. True. Because the first time you get up and you make a blunder, I'm telling you, if you don't take care, you will not do it again. Because the two times I spoke on the floor, I was, you know, I was very cautious of myself, and I had to make it so short because I was afraid that, hey, if you don't take care, and you, because there are certain words that are unparliamentary.
True.
It's not everything that they say on the floor. So if you don't take care, and you use your proper, your platform, your radio or whatever platform,
lifestyle
to go and
you'll be in trouble.
And the people start hooting at you. If you don't take care, you will not get
I know, the hoot actually comes from the far end.
That is our job. That is our job. We only have to shout and make noise, to intimidate you, whoever.
I feel that sometimes.
And that's exciting, you know. And it's not a serious, you can see somebody say, sit down and all those things.
Sit down.
It doesn't really.
You know who I remember most about? That Fritz Bafo. And he has a deep voice. And you can hear him from the far corner.
Yeah. And we have George Anda, who has a very loud voice.
Really? So now he's country.
But George is a minister, so, you know, ministers, they have to be. But we, the floor members, who make that. But, you know, the feminine voices, you can't hear it much. But I think next I will amplify my voice so I can be heard more. Yeah. But it's exciting. That one is on the lighter side, because after the hooting, you see both sides together. That one doesn't really, really affect anybody. It's just the fun of it. But when you're on the floor speaking, and you don't speak well, if you don't take care, you'll be in trouble. So those are the basic things. But on the whole, the committee work is the studying stages, you know. That is where the budget is discussed, you know, before it comes to the floor. You have to go into details, what this money is going to be used for. You critique it, even though it is your party, you still have to, because if you don't take care and it comes to the floor, and, you know, you pamper the minister together with the committees, you know, and it comes to the floor and there's any blunder, then we will be in trouble. So even in the committee level, you have to critique. It doesn't matter if it's the IGP, because our committee deals with the minister, all the law enforcement agencies, the police, the army, the marine, the peacekeeping, the NADMO, whatever. Is on our committee, so we have to make sure that we criticize it. Where their money is not enough, we talk about it and we think about how they can improve, increase their, you know, finances so they can do better. And where we think it is too much, we can talk about it. But my committee is such a sensitive committee that we don't talk about our money outside. Some of the things that we don't even bring, even when they have to come to the floor of parliament, there should be no camera. So unfortunately, the committees that I am, I can't talk about our finances, because it's a very delicate committee.
It looks like you're a perfect member of the committee, because even your strategies for coming into power, you kept them submarine. And so,
and I've come to a submarine
committee, so I think you're on track. How do you feel about that?
I think sometimes I said maybe I should have gone to the police. I should have been a detective or something, because I'm good at those things, you know. I watch a movie and then from the beginning I can perceive where it's going to end, and my husband is like, how do you know? Because when they start, I said, this person is going to be the bad one. So I observe those things. So when I'm dealing with people and they are not very good,
I can clearly tell.
I'm not perfect, you know. We all have our weak points, but I can, you know, perceive who is genuinely. And in politics, you have to know the genuine people around you.
True.
Yeah, you have to know the genuine people around you. It is not an easy vocation at all. Politics is not.
When you say it's not easy, what do you mean?
Oh, in politics, 1 + 1 can never be 2 in politics. I'm telling you.
It can be 3, it can be 1.
It can be 0. The people that you think you click with, you know, you would hear or see something and you're like, wow.
The same people.
And the people can be plants and they can be with you through and through, but they will still be plants. They are not genuine, you know. But whatever I do, it's for my, that is me.
Yeah.
That is me, because I am into politics to make a name. Mm-hmm. And to help the community that I represent. That is the main reason why I went into politics. And it is from my heart that I want to do something and leave a name. Mm-hmm. I am not a rich person, but it is not for money.
Mm-hmm.
Because even before politics, anytime I'm interviewed, I tell people that everything that we have, we will die and leave behind.
That's true.
Everything, just one day, even sitting here, if I die now.
You're gone.
I'm gone, and I will not take anything with me.
Leave nothing.
But the legacy I have left, the people that I have imparted something to, those people, I will be on their memory forever. Mm-hmm. And there are people that when you help today, they will also in turn help others.
True.
So people who know me, my friends, they know that because I always told them, way, way, way back, I'm like, if every household can adopt one child, that child may not necessarily live in your house.
Just take responsibility.
Just pay the fees. Just provide the feeding. This world will be a better place. Because a lot of people have more than enough. So in my house, when they throw food away, I'm screaming. Because there are people who are hungry. And I have taken on so many children who are now my children. Some of them live with me in my school. Some of them come to school for free. And I pay for. Because those are the basic things that I think we are put in this world to do. I, growing up, together with my sibling, it's like, it is my mother. The way she behaved has impacted us. So in politics, it is not so much about money, but there are people who are in it solely because of money. So people will kill, people will
do
occultic things, people will do whatever, just to retain power. And I'm just excited about the power, that is all. But, and work, it is not so much what you are going to get out of it. Because at the end of the day, what is it? People queued to vote for us. I go to a village and you look at the saucepan that they are cooking in.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no way that you use that to cook for your dog in the
house.
It
is true.
And these people go and queue and vote.
They queue for hours.
4 hours. And I ask myself, what benefits are they going to derive from what they are doing for us? But they do it for us. And then we come and sit in the comfort of our homes and we forget about them. And I don't think God will forgive us. And so if you watch, I don't want to mention because I'm on telly. Whilst we were in school, I'll mention name.
Okay.
Whilst we were in school, there was this one rich, prominent Kwame Nkrumah's guy's sons who came to visit us in school. And anytime they came to school to visit us, they were coming in their Benzes and all those things. Today, some of them are security in UK.
Wow.
Yes. Because if you get ill-gotten money and live with your children, God will not even bless
that
money.
Believe so.
Yeah.
I also
but if you work hard, you strive to get it,
you pass it on.
Fine. So if we take money from the poor, the people who don't even have water to drink, the people, I went to a village. It's called Abodjuse.
Abodjuse.
And they came to serve. I was going with my assemblyman. He was contesting, so I was going around with him. I got there, and they served us water. When I saw the cup coming, the cup itself, without seeing the water.
Discouraged you.
When they brought the water.
You got discouraged.
Everybody passed on.
Are you serious?
Even assemblyman.
Did not drink.
I wish he was listening. What I did to him afterwards, everybody passed on and it came to me. And there was no way I could say I would not drink.
You did?
I did. I had to. And throughout the meeting, I'm like, oh my God.
You can't wait to get out of here.
Oh my God. So when we sat in the car, I said, are you crazy? It is your election.
How do I drink this water for you?
What? Why didn't you drink the water? So anytime we are going there, we had to carry bags of sachet water to them. Not because I was afraid they were going to give me the same water to drink again, but I realized that there are people who needed these things. And the passionate thing is the old women and children. I go to the villages and I see them and I'm in love with them.
Mm.
I am just in love with those people. On Monday, I'm going to have a party for them in Yakrum.
Oh.
All the old ladies and old men. I'm going to have a big party for them.
You can officially invite people you want to just look into the camera and tell whoever you want to invite into.
Oh, I'm inviting I've already seen my constituency polling station and coordinators and all that already. On Monday, that is the first. It's a new year. I'm doing a program for the older people in the community, the people that we want to grow up to be like them.
Mm.
It's not that they don't have to eat, but it's a party. They're going to have dancing competition and all that. They are exciting program. Me papa no ma 70 years and above. We have a hen party. You're a dancing competition. ye be so na ye nwa ji na ye ze ye ze a osha afufufu na nyankopon oza ma hene me bom pe de nyame na dwoma ejoda boto hene ya ba ahemfu na hema nyina ye tunsa from hon na me police station fu nyina constituency fu boto mu abenyina so ye from hon na waba na enyi hene ma menom edi afufufu na nyankopon za ma hene
ono abo ye nso na tu ye be ba hobi.
No problem.
But before that, I think we need to take a quick break and we'll be right back. This is One-on-One Live on a back to One-on-One Live here on Net2 TV. You can also watch us live on Facebook at Net2 TV GH. And my name again is Jonas Abedienim. I'm hosting Honorable Mrs. Cynthia Morrison, the MP for Agona West. And she's also serving on a couple of committees and also in the ECOWAS Parliament. Is it Pan-African Pact? I don't know why I keep saying the ECOWAS Parliament. But Honorable, welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
It got interesting behind the scenes when we went on break. Tell us more about this party you're doing for the older and the young or the kids in your constituency.
Yeah, I'm doing only for the older.
Only for the older.
Yeah, not for the kids now. The kids who plan something else. Every year I do something for a group of elderly people. I've done it for Abodom, I've done for Kwaman, I've done for Bobikuma, I've done for Nkum, and this time I'm doing for Nyakrum. Mm-hmm. And then the next time, maybe Easter, I'll do for Suedru, which is the bigger community. I'm doing this because it is my passion, you know, to meet the elderly people. A few gifts here and there, food for them to eat and drinks and all that, just to give them some excitement. Anytime I do these things for them, I remember my mother, you know, while she was alive, every Mother's Day was her day.
Mm.
But when I got into politics, she agreed that every Mother's Day I do programs for the elderly people in my community.
That's nice.
Yes, she sacrificed that. She passed on this year.
May her soul rest in peace.
Yes, and since she's passed on, all the love that I had for her,
you give it
which
all.
I can't continue to. This Christmas I've been so sad because there's no mother to go and give a Christmas present to. I used to spoil her a lot. So all those things I'm going to do for the other mothers. And I told her even before she passed on, because I saw her pass on.
Mm.
She was getting frailer and frailer. So I told her that when you are no more, all the love and attention I give to you, I'm going to give for other mothers. And she agreed. So whatever I'm doing is in memory of my beloved mother who made me who I am today. So I'll do it for them. For the love and for everything. Food is nothing. It will cost so much to do for like, there are almost like 2,500 people that I'm going to organize this program for. The last time I did in Bukuma, some of the women said, we haven't seen some of our friends in years, even though we live in the same community.
So there's a connection back again after years.
Some like 85 year old, and she can't even walk, and she's holding a stick. So who takes her out?
That's true.
The only place she goes to is that they put her in front of her.
The house or the room?
Not house, the room. Theirs is not like a house. It's the, you know, from the room you go, you step. So they put her right in front of her door, and some of them are even in the room throughout. So during these occasions, they carry them and they bring them. And then they see a friend that she hasn't seen in like 5 years. And some of them were like saying, yeah, 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 kwa won, yeah, 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 fanta, you know.
Oh.
And they didn't put warrior here, won't serve you.
Oh.
So during, you know, these festive seasons like this, they have enough, at least some cake and biscuits and drinks
something
and food, you know,
up.
To cheer them up. Not only for the food, but for the companionship, the old time bonding.
Yeah.
And I remember we went to Abodom to have a Mother's Day program, Ikwaman. And they played Dravenya number one. And they were so
excited. Was dancing.
And one of them was like, Abremi son, Abrentena, Minipueno.
Oh,
and
it
was like, wow.
Old memories.
And so they're going to play them old school because they don't enjoy our rhythm.
No,
so
not
they're
anymore.
Going to play them old school. And when they play the old school, you see them with their walking sticks.
Trying to shake their bones.
Oh, and they do. And they do. Some of them
this
really
go
down and they come up. Very, very exciting. And so that is all we're going to have on Monday.
Mm.
A lot of dancing, a lot of merrymaking, just the exposure, the excitement.
I already feel I'm part of the atmosphere.
Yeah.
I was brought up by my grandmother, so I know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But don't you think such events should be organized more frequently than just once in a year? And
I can't do that all the time, unfortunately. I don't have the resources to do that all the time. That is why occasionally, like Mother's Day, like Christmas, like Easter, if I had the resources to do it all the time, I would do it. But I'm doing a home where the mothers can come and sit for comfort.
Mm.
I'm building a home where occasionally we'll bring a group of mothers. You know, I went to Denmark to look at their old people's home, and it's exciting. They are kept, they have recreation, they have food, but we can't do exactly what they are doing in there. And it is being paid by the taxpayer.
Mm.
So until we get there in Ghana, but we in my own small way, I'm just doing a community center where the elderly people come and have fun.
We will visit it and we make sure we show it on TV.
And that will be in memory of my mother, my beloved mother. So I'll name it after her. Where we'll have, so anytime I see them, at least I'll see that, oh, I have a mother that, you know, is taking over, even though the original one is no more.
It's Christmas and the time of giving. Honorable Mrs. Cynthia Morrison is certainly giving to her constituency. We will come back into constituency, but since you're a member of the Privileges Committee of Interior and Defense, this is the time of the year again where you have all sort of security issues coming up, and what has the committee put in place, and how do you see it this time compared to last year, especially when you were not a member of the Privileges, the Defense Committee?
Yeah, we met the IGP Thursday before we rose on Friday, and then they spelled out their plans. And you know, as usual, security things, even though they told us in camera, we cannot say it here, but I see whatever they told us we're going to do.
It's been done.
I see, you know, anytime I go out, I see the policemen in town, I see people on bikes, I see all those things. But you know, they can't be everywhere, even in our homes. When you are in your bedroom, you don't see what the children are doing in the hall. Occasionally, there'll be some slips here and there. But with the traffic, I can see they are managing traffic so well. With the crime rates, I haven't heard much. Only this morning when I was coming, I heard from the same studio that some armed men went to Dansoman to rob a young man who is a vendor, you know, those
mobile money,
whatever. And then listening to the scenario, how the girl was explaining, I could see that there are people who knew the guy.
Mm-hmm.
Because he said they were strangling him.
Oh.
And they had guns. So if they wanted money, they could have just pointed at him and taken the money. But they were struggling with him. They were trying to kill him, you know, not with a gun, but
with
their bare hands. Meaning, I'm sure when the police investigate, they realize that there are people that a guy knows already. Mm. So those ones are one out of whatever. But seriously, I can see, you know, a little management here and there, and I pray that the rest of the season wouldn't hear any negative, you know, disaster or whatever, like crime, shooting and all those things. Yeah. But the fraud, as for fraud, you know, it's been there and people will still remain naughty. But I pray that the police, for whatever, because seriously, when we had a meeting with the IGP, whatever he said makes sense, and I believe that they're going to work, and I can see a little of it already being done.
How do you see Ghana's security system or security structure in the next 12 months?
Next 12 months. I'm foreseeing not even 12 months. You see, the problem we're having in Ghana, that I have said once in my committee, that I can talk about it here, is that because the young men don't have jobs and ladies, once they hear recruitment, everybody wants to go there.
Yeah.
Because for police or for the security agencies, when you get the job, is secured. So everybody wants to go to the police. Everybody wants to go to the military. Is it that we want to go to the police or military? Or is it that we don't have a job, so we would opt for that one? When we do that, we get all sort of negative people.
Mm-hmm.
People who don't have passion. Yesterday, I was talking to a doctor, and I told another doctor, when you are training them, tell them to be passionate about their jobs. Is it that she's only intelligent, so they're going to medicine?
Some are actually forced by their parents. I want to have a doctor as a son.
The passion is not there. The person goes into it. So for the police, it's happening. It's the same thing. So we have policemen who are crooks, policemen who are criminals, policemen who are there only for the love of money. But if we genuinely want to train them, they go through the recruitment system right from school. They join the cadets. You see the activities. They are trained from school. So right from school, we know that these people are being shaped and groomed for the military or for the police. Along the line, if that person does not fit in, that person will opt out.
Mm-hmm.
But when the person is only 23, 25, and the only option is that there's no job, so I want police, He goes into the police with no passion, and the money that he was expecting. So the only thing is that he goes on the street to collect some few monies here and there. So we should restructure the recruitment system. We should restructure it. I think when we restructure it and we put things in place, we make sure that, oh, these people that we are going to recruit, they are people who are groomed, they are people who have the passion for the job that they are going to do. These people that we are going to recruit are strong, able people already. And when they fail their test, it may be one or two slips here and there, but not that I know MP, so I'll give my forms to the MP for the MP to go and look for placement for me in the police, and then a person goes in there and then doesn't go with any good intention or motives. So those are the challenges that I have with the recruitment system. And I've talked about it in the committee, I've told the Interior Minister, and I will push it on and see what we can do if we can start from the school. Almost every school has cadets. So the police, they should deploy
them. No, they even have it from like the primary.
I run a school. I have cadets, and you see the younger children.
Yeah, they're more active.
In there. It's beautiful. So we should continue hitting it. Because when I told the Interior Minister, he so agreed. He was so interested. He said, I think that is so right. So I'll still push him. Because we can do it from there. And we don't have that stress of lobbying for space and all that, that you become a bad person because you were not able to help somebody go to the police or the military or whatever. But it is not, even though I'm in the committee, I don't call the shots there.
That's true.
I don't do the recruitment, you know. At best, maybe if you can push for one. But we are like, how many? 275 people in parliament.
And if everybody else is pushing for one,
already 275 is gone.
Yeah.
We have the leadership, we have the ministers, we have all the...
And
we
their
have
spouses.
Their spouses. And we have the security people themselves who want their wards to be there. So we are looking for 20,000. Already is exhausted. But nobody understands you. It's like I've given my forms to MP.
And
MP
I
has
get.
To get me a place and I must get. Somebody even who gets disqualified says, I know that with protocol you can push. How do I push when you are disqualified? If we structure it well, and everybody knows that this is the way it goes, nobody would even want to push anything anyway. The children themselves, knowing very well that they want to go to military or they want to go to the police service or they want to go to customs or whatever, will go through the right channel from school. And then it will be a smooth sailing something. We'll have hitches here and there. It's a human institution. But at least at the end of the day, it will be better than what we are seeing now.
That is so true. That is so true. Honorable, I'll give you a few minutes to wish a few people, special people, a Merry Christmas, and we go on from there.
The most special person in my life is my dear darling husband, Herbert Morrison of Morrison Associates, and my beautiful children. I wish them all the best. I wish them Merry Christmas. He sacrificed so much because he's a home person. He's a good food person. But in politics, I can't do the very good food that I had time to do all the time. And he understands so well. Darling, I love you so much. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And to my beautiful children, Daniel, Gladys, Esther, Hebertha, Herbert and Hubert, and Hectoria. You know, I have seven of them.
Wow.
I wish them all the best. I wish them Merry Christmas. And Stella, I wish you Merry Christmas. I wish my sibling, I wish I'm done with my family. And I wish the number one gentleman of the land, Nana Adodankwa Akufo-Addo, and your beautiful wife, Rebecca, my mother and my friend, I wish you Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I wish the Central Regional, the National Executives, the Central Regional Chairman, Chairman One, Chairman Kuti, strongest man, you know, no nonsense man, that's for him. He handled Central Region like his own business, and he succeeded in getting us 19 seats, and all the executives that work with you. Regional Minister now, Kwame Duncan, and, you know, Ajay Bafu, and all the executives, Joe Donko, KK, Imbro, our number one special gentleman. He was the research man, and he worked so well, so tirelessly to win us our victory. And for all the people, my constituency, from the chairman right down to the youth organizer, all the coordinators, the polling station executives, the chiefs, the people of Aguna West, everybody who made this victory a success, I wish you all the best. When it comes to the chamber, I wish my speaker, hey, gentlemen, you see his workings in parliament.
Yeah.
He's a guy, old chrome. Speaker, I wish you Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. You made our year so beautiful. Our number one, Nana Doctor, Chairman Sabonsu, and all the others. And I wish my leader in Pan-African, Honorable Joe Weiss.
Yeah.
He is my chairman for Privileges and Interior. He's my mentor. He's a very good gentleman. Yeah. I go with him to South Africa, and he is the leader. But because I'm the only woman on the committee, and he gives me all the preference. Leader, I appreciate you. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I'm learning so much from him. And for all my friends and loved ones, I wish you all well. And now I come to my main man, Akompreku, the strong man, my brother and my friend. I wish you Merry Christmas. We are always fighting because I don't understand him. And he's always saying certain things. He says I'm a menopause woman, so he doesn't move with me. He moves with the girls. Akompreku, he says, I never say mouseka. I wish you all the best and I wish you God's blessings. You've been a mentor in not only Central Region. And it's not because I'm on your studio. I wish you well. I wish you God's blessings. I wish that this studio will move from strength to strength. Every money that you invest in people, God will bless you. Amen. You're a strong man. You speak your mind. Sometimes you speak it in the way that I don't understand you. But you understand. I'm praying that God will protect you because I know that so many people don't like you.
Yeah.
But because you speak the truth, and I know it is the truth that you speak, sometimes you go overboard, but you speak the truth. God will bless you, and God will establish the every penny that you spend on people. You allow him to go overboard and overboard. But who cut Kennedy? The other than the mother said, "Ma kosi diwa komo mo wani sa mo mo ma Kennedy mbahu biyum." Men do fear na miti so akasa o studio.
He actually stopped coming for a while.
For a while, he will come. Yeah, but he goes to other studio and then he goes to say, but I like him. I like him so much. I'm not flattering him. He knows I'm not flattering. Yeah. He knows I won't flatter him. I will tell him when he's right. But you're a good guy. May God bless you. May God bless all the people around you. Auntie Stella, I love you so much for having patience for this my brother, for marrying him and making him a nice gentleman. Auntie Stella, you're Michelle. Auntie Edneny. I'm dead. I'm food. I'm papa. Auntie, I work Kennedy. I'm a Kennedy. And you want a Kennedy on you. I would say Kennedy, why Kennedy? Yeah, Michelle, that's simply brave.
Wow, that's a long message. We will come for your Christmas message of the year. But since this is the last episode of this show, One on One Live, I would like to also take the opportunity to mention Focus, Sappho, Bente, Alex, Peter, Robert Finn, Jane Fee, Kenneth, a Japan Junior, Kenny Egi, you've been the boss, man. I know you're busy with your Africella, which I'm representing. I need my tickets anyway. I need 2 tickets. And then all the production crew, like management, Albert, we need some cash. Well, and we also open this show to sponsorship. So if you have products, if you have ideas, if you want to come on board, we are open. And next year we are planning this show. We're going on a bigger platform, we're giving it more hours, and we're bringing stronger and very resourceful people like Honorable Mrs. Cynthia Morrison and the likes to come and grace this show. So keep watching One on One Live. I will be here. We're beefing up our team, the 2 Television. We're taking it beyond the limit. Before we leave, I will let Honorable Cynthia Morrison give us a special message for the Christmas. I'm not forgetting you, the first gentleman of the land. I salute you. I salute you and I salute you again. Your Excellency, the man with power, the man of few words, the man full of action, President Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, you are my mentor. You've been the man. We can all tell from how Ghana is going and what you said and what you're doing. Also, to your wife, Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo. I had the privilege to be with her on few programs, and she's really, really a mother. She is a mother, trust me. Your ADC and all those, Auntie Coco at the squad, and Manuel, all the people in the First Lady's office, I salute you. You guys are doing a good job. Jacob, all of you, Richard, and also in the president's office.
Perpetua.
The names are a lot, but you guys, you're doing a wonderful job and keep it up. We're too really, and we're really to partner you guys to the end and beyond. We just want you guys to keep calling, keep telling us, keep inviting us, and we just do it for you. Let's go back to Honorable Mrs. Cynthia Morrison. We would just like you to give us a brief message for the Christmas.
Christmas is a stressful time. Everybody wants to enjoy. Everybody wants to go to town. Let's drive carefully. carefully and get home safe. Let's be protective of ourselves. The security can be everywhere, so let's lock up and let's talk to our children when they are going out. They should be very careful. It's in our cars, so we should make sure that the doors are locked so that we'll not have any accidents on the road. When I say accidents, not only car accidents, but people burgling into our cars and all that. I pray that when we are eating, we should remember the less privileged. If it's possible, even if it's a little bag of rice, you can take to a home, you can give to a neighbor, you can give to somebody who is in need. And let's make this Christmas a beautiful one. It is not only the churches that we have to give money to. We should learn to give money to the less privileged. Because some churches have so much. Me, myself, my church, we have so much. I don't know whether my pastor is listening, but we have so much. In Emmanuel Methodist Church, I don't think we need so much money. There are people out there who need money. There are people out there who are hungry. Let's build places for convenience for people who are in need. Let's create places where we can put hot meal for people to eat a day. Let's all help to make Ghana a better place. And for the Kayai and all that, I know Otiko is taking good care of them. Honorable Otiko is taking good care of them. And but for the rest who are less privileged, we should also help them. And we should make Ghana a better place. We pray that next year, NET2 will be bigger and better than we are seeing now. And on this behalf, also, I want to greet Keke, my man, strong man. I don't know whether he sleeps or not. You hear his voice very early in the morning on radio.
Late
at night. And I'm like, Keke, what is your wife doing at home? Why are you like this?
He loves what he's doing. Yeah.
But for Keke, Michelle, as for Fifi, he's left us a little. But Fifi.
Fifi, come back.
Fifi, he was serving Ghana, so he won't come back. He'll come back occasionally.
Yes, that's what I mean.
Ghana better.
We need him on this show. We need Fifi to come and tell us a few about this.
Let Agric work. You are working with my boss, oh. Agric minister is my sweetheart. So Fifi, let Agric work for me. And my sanitation minister, we have to start. He wants me to be an ambassador for the schools.
I'll go
to the schools and talk to the children about sanitation. We are starting that in January. Mm. Because sanitation is what I want.
Mm.
If the country is clean, there'll be, sickness free also. Sure. So from January, NET2, you move around with me.
You're willing to
go to the
you.
Schools to talk to them about sanitation, how to keep the environment clean. Because one thing I've noticed is that when we train the child will in turn train the mother. Because when you tell a child that don't drop this thing here, he will not drop. And when he sees the mother or father drop, he will
say, don't do that.
Don't do that. Because when you sit in a car with a child and the traffic gets red, the child will tell you,
it's
red, stop. Because they have a rhyme that says, when you see the traffic lights, red means stop.
That's true.
So they'll tell you to stop. So when we start inculcating good character into the child will in turn correct the adults. Because adults, we've made up our own characters already.
That's true.
Built up characters already that formed. We can't change. Mm-hmm. It is difficult to change an adult, but it is very easy to change a child.
True.
Even after sanitation and we are drinking, the moment we finish cleaning, somebody drinks and put
and
them
drop it, yeah.
Just where we have finished cleaning, because it is something that he has built already. But when you train a child,
they will not repeat
and
it.
They will not repeat it, and they will tell you, "Mommy, you said we shouldn't do this.
So why
Mommy, you said when we are eating we shouldn't talk. Why are you talking?" So that is what I thought of, and the minister has so agreed that he wants me to do this. So from January, we are going to start moving from school to school. And I have even said that for the tax system, we should teach the child in school. When you go to America, they give them assignments.
Mm-hmm.
They will tell you, we are giving you $2 to go shopping.
Yeah.
Prepare your budget. And the child will write candy, $1, soda, this, that. He will not spend all the $20. Mm-hmm. And he write plus tax.
Mm-hmm.
He will add the tax to it to get $20. Without the tax, you don't get it.
Yeah.
And so the child right from school knows that everything
there's something called tax.
There's something, but we don't know. How do I grow up and go and sell and you say I should give some of the money to you? It is my money.
Who are you?
So when we start training them from school, we start training them when they come and register the company. You start training them that once you have registered company, this percentage goes to this. You have to register. And then it becomes simpler for them and then they know. But if you don't and we grow up, even with me, it's difficult. This morning, they are just seeing me for money, and it is difficult. I'm going to take so much to go and pay tax. But when we do it right from school, character formation is from childhood.
That is true.
And we grow. America is not America because of today. They know. Their children know. Go to UK. The older women, they are sitting right. Their bed is put right by the window. They are watching everything
everywhere
that is going on. They care for their land.
Yeah.
They care. So any little thing, they see a car pass. They don't know this guy in this neighborhood. It has passed twice. They call the police. Car number so, so and so has passed. But ours, because of lack of education, we can't even, you do not go to school. How do you, you know, memorize car number?
Oh, I don't really think it all boils down to lack of education.
Yeah, it is. Because you see, when you train them, they know, we don't even care. You see somebody pass, what is the color of that shirt? You don't even remember.
That I agree. Some people
you don't remember. Yeah. The man that came here, what shirt was he wearing? You don't know.
Yeah.
But the white boy or white old woman will tell you, the haircut is like this, he had a scar on the left cheek.
Yes.
The moment they look at you, they sight you and they keep it
it's
there.
It's the training and
it's the training, that's what I'm saying.
I first trained, or probably went to school in America, so I know some of these things, and I always get worried. But I like it when people like you in power and people in position are beginning to feel this heat, and so I believe you start bringing the policies and ideas that will help others to buy into this idea, and we will kind of develop it gradually.
Gradually.
This conversation is getting very interesting, but time is not on our side. Yeah. I would like to continue with my season's greetings. I haven't forgotten about my second man on the land, Honorable, Your Excellency, President, Vice President. Aliu, Bawumia, and no, your family. Yes, we did not forget about you. And also my boss, the group chair. You've had a lot of shout out on this show, so I would like to keep mine brief and simple. You are the man. Yeah, he was on the show a few days ago, and I was amazed. He had actually, as part of his resolutions for the year, he's forgiven everyone that's wronged him, including Anijo. Because I was expecting him to go after Anijo next year. He said he'll go after him, but he said he's forgiving him, and he sounded so real and so true, and that is him. I know him personally. And we thank you also, Madam Stella, for being there for us. We know the heat is on. You know we have our challenges, but we still keep going forward. We appreciate you, and you have our support. You've been in the seat, you've been steering affairs, and we appreciate every bit of it, managing, putting things together. You've been a mother for all. We all say thank you and wish you a Merry Christmas. Before we sign up, we are basically going to get our production crew to come here and say the last Merry Christmas waves. Feel free, come on the set. You guys have all done a good job. This is Safo, this is...
Official part.
You guys have done a good job. This is Safo. Hey, focus, come on. You guys have done a good job. We know we started this show not long ago, but you've made it work. Bente, you've done well. Alex, DJ Wajia Kunya. Oh, Kwesi Nissen, he's done good. Yes. He's a birthday boy, celebrating his birthday.
Wow.
You guys have done well. Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Born on Christmas. It's your only Jesus prayer, and I said Robert Finn, you guys have done a wonderful job, and we are glad to have our honorable with us. I think we've come to the end of the show. And hey, JP, the one technician. JP, you're trying to let us do this by next year. We have to get to our target. And that's how we also make catch up. But we thank you guys all for making it successful. Hey, Palos, get well soon. Palos, our editor, get well soon. We need you back in the office. Yeah? We thank you all, and we'll see you again. Kenneth, we're coming to the Africella night.